So are we on now?
Oh, Chiara, I hear it's right. snowing in Rome.
It what? Should be.
It's snowing in Rome today. It's
snowing in Rome.
Yeah.
Right, so I believe we're live on Facebook.
Yeah.
I'm we are. Now, we should be now live on Facebook.
Venue's possible. Yes, we are live on Facebook. I'm going to quickly just quieten my Facebook up. So I like this. Then I'll share this. Do I need to join a watch party here? What do I need to do?
Yeah, if you make a watch party, you can leave it running.
So how do I do that?
Just create watch party or something along those lines.
I'm on it. I don't see any opportunity to do that.
Well, I think when you post it, it says what... That's how it used to be. But
share now, public. Share on your timeline. Share now, story. I don't know how to do what you're asking me there.
Oh, right. It's shared, I think, so.
Right, you do know you're sharing every screen on Facebook at the moment. Everyone can see everything, yeah? You know that?
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine for now.
Yeah? Yeah. Is everyone aware of that? Have you told everyone in the room that everyone can see everything?
All right, Stephen.
Just to let everyone know. Everybody?
Yeah.
Steve, it's live.
You're actually live, Steve.
Okay.
And then we'll have some explaining to do in a moment, I'm sure. Right, share now. Okay, so should we get cracking?
Yeah.
Are we sharing
it? Yeah, we've got a few people. Is everyone sharing? Everyone doing your share bits? Wait, everyone's just tuned in. Welcome to the open mic online event for Venues Possible. We've got a few people in now. So I'm trying to be given the go-ahead to commence. So we good, Joe? Shall I start with a little intro and get us going?
Yeah, let's do it. And let's start.
Okay. So if you've tuned in, guys, hello, welcome. My name's Clint, if you don't know who I am. My name's written at the bottom here at the moment. Okay, so welcome. This is for Venues Possible online open mic night in conjunction with Speckled Hen. If you've come before, you'd have seen us down there. Obviously, it's with the lockdown. We can't do a live event, so we're online. So we've got some great artists for you tonight. Firstly, we're going to have a little chit-chat with JD, so I'm going to pass you over. But also, it's in conjunction with SG1 Radio. I believe that they're pinging it out there. And the event today is in aid of the feed-up warm-up, if you're aware of what that is. Great charity. There is a donation link, and there will be one flicking around. But without further ado, I'm going to hand you over to my esteemed colleague, Mr. JD.
Thank you, Clint. Hey, guys, out there in Zoom and Facebook land. How are you all? Welcome back. It's lockdown crazy time again. So, what's happening? We've gone back to our fantastic open mic performance, and we've got some great artists, as Clint has said. I'm going to introduce you to the first one who's, I think he's very, very poor. He can't even afford a t-shirt. What the hell is going on with it? Who knows? Well, anyway, he's a really good friend of mine. He's a pretty damn good musician, singer. I do love listening to him. It's the great, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the great Mr. Steve Turnbull. Oh yeah, let's give him the clap he deserves. Take that how you will. Steve, how you doing, my friend?
I'm all right, JD. Great to be here. Thanks to Venues Limited, and thanks all to you hosts and fabulous musicians for being here. And it's going to be a very, very good evening.
Great stuff. So, Steve, tell us a little bit about yourself. What are your influences?
My influences go back quite a long way, as far as sort of the 70s, with guys like Bruce Springsteen, James Taylor, Neil Young, but also through many decades to now, to guys like George Ezra and Jerry Simon, who you might hear a bit of.
Right, guys, can I just ask, whoever's got the telly on in the background, can you mute yourself, please? Thank you. Oh, it'd be even better if Joe, I think you're the host, can you just mute everyone else and just leave me and Steve talking?
I will do, yeah.
Thank you, Joe. In control, my friend. So, Steve, back to you. You good? So, what are you going to be giving us tonight? Anything from those influences?
I will indeed, and I will start with a song by a young man who has a lot more clothes than me right now, but his name is George Ezra.
Are you getting a little cocky now, are you?
Do you know what? I would love him for at least to lend me like a Nike t-shirt right now.
Yeah, but... it would be useful, but you watch out for those bum notes. And anyway, Steve, over to you, my friend. Off you go.
Homegrown alligator, see you later. Gotta hit the road, gotta hit the road. Well, something changing the atmosphere, architecture unfamiliar. I could get used to this. Well, time flies by in the yellow and green. Stick around and you'll see what I mean. And there's a mountain top that I'm dreaming of. If you need me, you know where I'll be. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. Well, south of the equator, navigator, gotta hit the road, gotta hit the road. Well, a deep sea diving around the cops, bikini bottoms, lager tops, I can get used to this. Well, time flies by in the yellow and green. Stick around and you'll see what I mean. And there's a mountain top that I'm dreaming of. If you need me, you know where I'll be. But I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. We got two in the front, two in the back, sailing away, and we don't look back. We got two in the front, two in the back, sailing away, and we don't look back. Well, time flies by in the yellow and green. Stick around and you'll see what I mean. But there's a mountain top that I'm dreaming of. If you need me, you know where I'll be. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. Well, I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone.
Yeah.
Yeah, we really were clapping that, mate. It's unfortunately I was on mute.
I thought it was a silent disco.
Yeah, no. So, yeah, crack on, please. Carry on. You play on through. Entertain us, sir.
Lovely. All right. This is a song, I think, lyrically, that we can relate to right now. Lean on Me is certainly appropriate right now.
Sometimes in my life, we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, I'll be your friend, I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Please swallow your pride if you have things you need to borrow, for no one can fill those of your needs that you let go. You just go on, me brother, and I'll lend a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. You just might have a problem that you don't understand. We all need somebody to lean on, lean on me. When you're not strong, I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Please swallow your pride if you have things you need to borrow. Of your needs that you won't let show. You just call on me, brother, and I'll lend a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. You just might have a problem you don't understand. We all need somebody to lean on. If there is a load you had to bear, I'll help you carry on, for I'm right up the road. I'll share your load if you just call me, call me, call me. Oh, won't you call me, call me. Oh, won't you call.
Thank you so much. Thank you. All right.
I haven't ruined the layout of this, have I, by adding another person?
Thank you. All right. On these cold evenings, I kind of remind you of these kind of these beautiful summertime songs that you long for. So this is one of those.
You know I love my lady. We've been together so long. Like a worn-out recording from a favorite song. So while she lay there sleeping, I read the paper in bed, and in the personal column there was this letter that read, if you like pina coladas and getting caught in the rain, if you're not into yoga, and if you have half a brain, if you love making love at midnight in the dunes of the Cape, then you're the love that I look for. Write to me and escape. I didn't think about my lady. I know it sounds kind of mean, but me and my old lady were falling into that same old dough routine. So I wrote to the papers, took out a personal ad, and though I'm nobody's poet, I thought it wasn't half bad. If you like pina coladas and getting caught in the rain, I'm not much into health food, but I'm into champagne. I've got to meet you by tomorrow and cut through all this red tape. At a bar called Scrappy Malloy's, we'll plan our escape. Mm-hmm. So I waited with high hopes, and then she walked in the place. I knew her smile in an instant, I knew the curves on her face. She was my own lovely lady, and she said, oh, it's you. And I laughed for a moment, ha ha ha, I said, I never knew you liked pina coladas and getting caught in the rain and the feel of the ocean and the taste of champagne. If you love making love at midnight in the dunes of the cane, well, you're the lady I look for, write to me and escape.
Thank you very much. Thank you. All right.
Wow, that was amazing. Thank you so much. I think that, does that bring you to a closer?
I think I might have time for one more, if that's all right.
That's absolutely fine. One more, Joe. Yeah, give me the thumbs up.
Yep,
one more, go for it. Fantastic.
All right. Before I play that last song, I have to say, JD, now, my friend, you agreed to this.
You so, actually aren't, are you?
I'm afraid. Right, ladies and gents, those of you who are watching, JD, one of our wonderful hosts, has agreed to pay 50 quid to Feed Up, Warm Up, and donate it to them if I agreed to do this open mic with no clothes on. There's always that one guy who is prepared to do something crazy. That guy is me tonight. All right? But. So, JD, I'm so, so sorry to have put your 50 quid out of pocket, mate. But
mate, I tell you what, it's for a worthy cause, but I'll be the judge of whether you... We'll see.
All right. We're going to finish on this great song by Fleetwood Mac. Thanks very much. Hope you guys have enjoyed me. Some great artists yet to come.
That explains the lack of t-shirts. Of course. Why didn't I think of it? Okay. Or did I? When I was talking about you feeling cocky and bum notes. Who knows? No. Serendipity. Over to you, my friend.
All right.
Can you hear me calling out your name? You know that I'm falling and I don't know what to say. But speak a little louder, believe and shout. You know that I'm proud but I can't get the words out. And I want to be with you everywhere. Something's happening to me. I'm naked. My friends say I'm acting peculiarly. But come on, baby, we gotta make a start. We gotta make it soon before you break my heart. And I wanna be with you everywhere. To say, but Come on, baby, you better make a start. You better make it soon before you break my heart. And I wanna be with you everywhere. And I wanna be with you everywhere. I wanna be with you everywhere. I wanna be with you everywhere.
Proof.
Ladies and gentlemen, yeah, he proved it. You can get dressed now, Steve. I will definitely, I pledge, I will do it before we finish here. Joe, I'll send you the I will send you the money, my friend. Fair play, Steve. You put my money where my mouth is. Thank you for that. Good man. Well done. Well done. So, Roxy, how much do we need the audience to donate to get you to do the same?
I'm sorry, that will never ever happen in a million years.
Hang on, we heard a million. We heard a million.
Oh, never.
No, Steve.
Hats off to you, Steve.
Well done,
hats
my friend.
To hats off. A million.
Yeah. I ain't saying she's a gold digger. Yeah.
Okay, Steve. Come on, guys. Now we've now we're all off of mute. Take yourselves off of mute, guys.
I'm lost for words, mate.
Let's let's put our hands together for Stevie Turnbull.
Thank you very much,
Stevie Turnbull.
Amazing.
Glenn, back to you, my friend. It's back to you at the studio.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Half the press. Thank you. Awesome. Well. Either congratulations, wonderful, or apologies for that, whichever way you look at that. But it earned a lot of money for a good charity. So, Stephen, awesome. You the man. And I'm, you know, I don't know which, at what point I looked up, but that was definite proof. Maybe nearly a little bit too much, but yeah. He definitely owes some money there, without a doubt. And God, if only I was ready at the screenshot button. But anyway, let's get back on to what's happening next. So, as far as I'm aware, I'm going to do a little interview, aren't I?
Yeah.
Yes, and it's with Roxy, so I kind of need her unmuted for this interview.
It's hello, me.
Oh, hello. Brilliant. Technology, very smooth. Okay. Welcome to the studio, Roxy.
Hello. I'm still a little bit flabbergasted by that, actually.
By the
hats off to you, Steve. That was awesome.
I mean, anyone that knows Steve well, that fair play, Steve. I didn't think he was going to do that. It's enough about Steve, that. Though. Over to you, Roxy.
Over to me?
It's interview time. I get to interview you now.
You get to interview me now? I thought I was on at 7:30, but it's all good.
Well, I mean, we've got to talk anyway. I mean, so look, it's going to cover probably that.
It's good. Let's do it. I'm all for it. I'm all for it. Yeah. Yeah, so, all for it.
We'll get some boring. It's going to be a bit boring and then a bit random, all right?
I like it. Go for it.
Go with it. Obviously, I can see there's definitely a goat thing you have, which I'm aware of. Roxy has a goat problem.
I have a massive goat problem.
She's not scared of them. They're not there to help her get over it. It's
No, I actually spent my birthday with goats.
What actually paid to go and hang with them?
Literally, pygmy goats. They are like, I'm obsessed with them, and I actually got to walk them on my birthday.
I understand that. I'm the sort of guy that would purposely go to a cat cafe.
Oh, I've been to a cat cafe. It was amazing.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. Anyway, that's not the question. The first question for you, obviously, is this. This is a bit of a dull one. We've got to go through the rigmarole first.
I understand.
So, how old were you when you started playing? And that's in regards to, I say, start with, like, was it, did you start firstly with guitar or vocals first? What happened, Rox? Talk to me.
Steve's face. I started singing first from a very young age. I was in Stagecoach and all that kind of malarkey. Then I went into West End. Then after West End, I went into another West End show. And then I picked up a guitar and didn't look back.
Okay, cool. Because I never knew that. I mean, I've we spoke loads, never spoke to you about that at all.
I never really talk about it, if I'm honest. I'm not the West kind of person to be like...
What were you in the West End while we're on that subject?
I was in Choo Choo Bang Bang, and I was in Mary Poppins as the little girl, the little one. Yeah.
Cool. So where would people find this footage, Roxy? It will probably be online somewhere.
YouTube and maybe Google.
Right, so how would we word that ideally to find that? Come on, you know where it is, you've seen it. Dish the info.
Probably Roxy Searle, Mary Poppins, or Roxy Searle, Choo Choo.
Okay, yeah, I'll write that down. Roxy Searle, Mary Poppins. I'd be checking that out, definitely. Okay, so that was, I was just interested, I never asked you that.
Okay.
But cool. So I think we could touch on this the other day, and this is always a funny one. And I'm not going to respond with my answer, but what was your first single you bought?
We spoke about this the other day, and I had a good hard think, and I'm pretty sure it was Steps.
Yeah,
and I was a massive Spice Girls fan, or it could even have been Shania Twain.
I was a Spice Girls fan.
I loved Shania Twain.
I had posters and stuff.
See, I kind of went the other side of it. My mum used to take photos of me dressed up as Baby Spice.
Really? And where would people go for this link? Okay, moving on. If you could pick any artist other than me,
right,
of course, to do a duo with, who would it be?
Oh, famous.
Irrelevant.
No,
I don't think the artist needs to be irrelevant, because it would definitely be me. But no,
Bryan Adams.
Bryan Adams.
A million percent. I am ridiculously obsessed with him, and I've seen him many times in concert, and I was in the front row with my mum, and he told me I was pretty.
Did he?
He did, and it was really funny because
he's a snake, isn't he?
No, he's gorgeous. He he threw his guitar pick at me, and it fell on the floor, and everyone like went silent, and I was all like, oh god, where did it go? And then all of a sudden I picked it up and was like, yeah. And a whole of like, I can't remember if it was Wembley, it wasn't Wembley, it was the O2. The whole of the O2 was like, yeah! It was amazing.
Did you hurt anyone else in the acquisition of that plectrum?
Yes.
Totally.
Okay. And I'd do it again.
I think you're allowed to take someone's entire arm out of the socket for a towel.
Oh, what's that say? Roxy did. Oh, we've got a chat here. I didn't.
Is someone chatting? What are they saying in the chat? I've got other questions, but I'm happy for people to throw stuff at you. Where is this chat? Of you speak.
Oh my god, I really wish that he did get me to sing When You're Gone. But no, he didn't. I'm really upset about that. Really upset me.
Yeah, why didn't you do it?
I would have if he had let me. I did actually tweet him beforehand and ask him if I could do a song with him, but I don't think he's into all Twitter and all that. He's actually a photographer as well, which is another reason why I love him, because I'm also a photographer. So,
okay, yeah. Enough about Brian, moving on. you love a bit of Brian, don't you?
Right. I really do.
I'm not even going to ask you any more questions about it. Original music from you, when?
Oh, see, when, this, where? I know, yeah. I can see Lewis's face right now. So I'm actually...
I'm asking so he knows when he might have some work. No, I'm joking.
No, we were talking about it literally the other day. So Steve Young is literally, as we speak, recording some guitar parts for me, and then it's going to go over to Lewis to do some bass for me, and then anyone else I can try and rope into doing it would be great. So hopefully in the next few months, it will be available.
Okay, next few months. So we'll harass you in a couple months, right?
Yes, yeah, please do.
Probably on that one. Right, who would win in a fight, squirrel or an owl?
A squirrel or an owl?
Yeah.
An owl, 100%.
Daytime and nighttime.
Daytime and nighttime. I mean, owls are just... Have you seen their claws?
Not the biggest.
Have you seen their beaks?
They're both
Is it like a barn owl, or is it like a tawny owl? Like, oh, I mean, barn. I love my owls.
Local barn owl, one of those black squirrels.
Honestly, local barn owls will tear it apart.
Okay, you're on the owl side of things. Keen on birds. Okay. Favorite dessert. Now it can't be one for you, I'm sure. Top three, Rob.
Okay. Desserts. Top three. I'm going to go for a toffee apple crumble. Definitely toffee apple crumble. I'm going to go for a chocolate. I'd have to have an antihistamine, but chocolate fudge cake.
Nice.
Oh, and then third thing. Oh God. Oh, a chocolate eclair.
That'd be one of mine. That'd be in there. Just surprised you're not here, a cold lemon meringue pie with hot custard. Shocked by that.
No.
Do not try that. Rock that one out, Roxy.
All right. I'll try.
Next time we're allowed to see you, I'll buy it for you. So you get on.
Okay, let's do it. Let's do it.
See if we can make it to the top five.
Probably 2022 by the time we're allowed out.
We'll do this at the end. I'll move this question down anyway. So, right, skis or snowboard?
Snowboard.
Knew it.
1,000,000%.
Really?
Never done either, but.
You're not? But no, you know the answer. No. If someone comes over to you, one of each, you're like, shut up, give me the snowboard, yeah? Totally hurt yourself, but you know, that's what I did.
Exactly.
Yeah, you look as cool as a skier when you're laid flat on the floor in pain.
It's true.
Okay. Okay. True. Favorite place to be other than at home? Because it can't be at home. Usually it might be for some people. Definitely
favorite place to be? Probably by the sea somewhere.
By the sea?
Yeah, I like the sea.
Cool, cool.
I'm yeah, by the sea somewhere.
Netflix or Amazon Prime?
Netflix. And I've got into Lewis suggested the Queen's Gambit.
I'm
obsessed now. I'm obsessed.
I watched the entire third season of Cobra Guy back to back in one night.
And I'm watching Prison Break as well. I'm on season 4 at the end of season 4, so I love Prison Break.
It doesn't finish a box series. Is it just me that gets about 4 series in and then forgets?
I can't know. I don't know how you can do that. I really don't.
Okay, have you ever been box cheated on?
Yes. By my parents. No. Yeah.
I just think the people that do that need to understand how that feels.
I know, because then you're like, well, and then they talk about it. And you're like, well, you can't talk about it.
Well, no, you know what happened. You're sat there with the person, and you know they're watching it, and you're going, oh, I wonder, and they're just like on their phone or something. And you're like, well, hang on. You've seen this. And then the pain and the hurt carries on. Okay, we'll move on from that one. I kind of know the answer to this anyway, but cars or motorbikes?
Motorbikes.
Coffee or tea, Rox?
It's got to be decaf because I'm allergic to caffeine, but decaf tea.
Duly noted, Roxy allergic to caffeine. What have you got in there then at the moment? What are you drinking at this moment in time?
Decaffeinated tea.
I've got some decaffeinated stuff, but I actually put coffee in it.
Okay.
Honest to God, this is true. I've got cappuccinos. I picked the wrong ones up. They're decaffeinated and they're horrible. So I put a coffee in it.
What you like?
Anyway, what's this? What is this?
Oh, it's the little boingy thing. Oh, I don't know.
You know what? You can have 1 point for that. It's called a vibra slap.
Fibre slap. Yeah, go again.
Take it.
Oh, that was loud. Dang.
My neighbours love me.
So loud.
Okay, Roxy, this is the final one for you.
Okay.
And it involves my ukulele.
Your ukulele. You've wanted to get this out for so long, haven't you?
Yes.
You're so looking the excitement on your face.
I'm last night for this, all right?
Look at the excitement.
There's going to be no lyrics for the minute, all right?
Okay.
Because that's the idea. The next stage is you're allowed a kazoo.
Okay.
And you should have it after that. If not, I'll sing it and it'll be really, really boring. And...
Okay.
Don't forget he's a drummer.
Yeah, point out I don't know if you play any other instruments. I'd like to stress that. Okay, I've remembered where I've got to go.
Okay.
Okay, ready?
Yes.
Jojo, if you don't mute something, I'm going to drive up to your house and touch you. All right? I don't know what you're looking at, but again. Oh, it's background.
Amidst the biggest human migrations in the Second World War, in the real world of planes, the most
journey that can be made. Yes, back in the room. Right. Okay, what's this song, Roxy? I'm laughing before we've started.
Thank you.
that, Rox?
Oh, it was amazing is what it was. It was brilliant.
Ignore the bad fingers there. Not designed for this sort of thing. What was it? Come on.
Lewis, I've literally just messaged you. Why aren't you messaging back? Literally, I've just asked what it is. I was asking Lewis for help.
Don't ask for help. You allowed that.
Yeah, go on. I'd like to hear it with that, please.
Yeah, it's good. I'm good. All right. That's an intro, right?
Come on, people. People, I've got it.
10 points, Roxy.
10 points. Thank you. Thank you so much. You know what?
Nothing tonight. Congratulations.
I mean, thank you so much. I mean, the quiz that we did the other night, I was really gutted that I didn't win any points. So this one means a lot. Thank you.
Do you know what? I think you didn't finish last, even though you went out after the first round.
Seriously?
Yeah. Because I think you did that, JD. Am I correct there? I think. Yeah. We actually ended up taking you out, so the person below you felt better.
Oh, that's good. Thank you.
Kind of
thank
wrong.
You for that. Thank you. I appreciate that.
Yes, no worries. Then. So, I don't really have any more questions for you, Robert. That was the main stuff I needed to cover myself.
Okay.
Let's talk about your goat thing. When did that start? When did your goat issue first raise its horns?
I've always loved goats, if I'm honest. I've always loved goats, so it kind of just, I mean, look at them. How can you not love this little face? Look at that little face.
I mean, they still got them down at, where is it? You can't go there now, but you know that little zoo?
Yes. There. Yeah, they do. Near Nebworth.
Meerkats, yeah, you can hang out there.
Great cheese.
Goat's cheese. Oh my God, it's like the best cheese in the world. I completely agree, Jedi. Completely agree. I love it. I can't
that
get over.
Really good.
I can't get over how just tasty everything is. And I mean, goats are just amazing.
It's not feta. I am. It's feta, I can't eat.
You can't. Oh, no, I'm not a feta person. Do you know what? After all of this, I kind of forgot that I was going to be singing. So I've got some bits and pieces that I'm going to be singing. Is that okay? Just some random bits.
Yeah. Well, what time are you starting now?
Yeah, is that okay? I thought you said that was the end of the questions.
Well, yeah, it is, unless you've got any.
Roxy, don't I have any questions for myself? Why am I in lockdown?
So tell me, Roxy, what do you think you can bring to this position?
I got bored, so I ate everything.
So I'm going to mute yourself now.
Okie dokie.
Speak to you in a bit.
All right, speak to you in a minute, buddy. Okay, so I'm going to do this song by Bruno Mars, and I hope you like it. If you ever find yourself stuck in the middle of the sea, I'll sail the world to find you. If you ever find yourself lost in the dark that you can't see, I'll be the light to guide you. I know when I need it, I can.
you're turning and you just can't fall asleep. I'll sing a song beside you. If you ever forget how much you really mean to me, every day I will remind you. I know what we need all when we are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me like 1, 2, 3. I'll be there. And I know when I need it, I can count on you like 4, 3, 2. You'll be there. Is that so fancy? I'm supposed to do all oh, yeah.
I'm gonna do this one because this one's one of my mama's favorites. So this one's for my mama who's sat on the sofa just over there. Hi mama.
Hello.
This one's for you. The Dawn Dem.
He's gone cold, I'm wondering why I got out of bed to go. The morning rain clouds up my window and I can see it all. Even if I could, it'd all be great. Put your picture on my wall. It reminds me that it's not so bad. It's not so bad. I drank too much last night, I got bills to pay. But man, just freezing pain. I'm just still pressing, they'll be here today. If I'm late for work again, but even if I'm there, they will all imply that I may not last the day. When you call me, it's not so bad. It's not so bad. Oh, wanna thank you for giving me the best day. The door, I'm home at last, and I'm soaking through the then you handed me a towel. Now all I see is you, and even if my house falls down, down, I wouldn't have a clue. Cause you're near me. And I wanna thank you for giving me the best day. Just to be with you, it's giving me the best day of my life. The best day of my life. The best day of my life.
So very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Okie dokie. I will do another one now if that's okay.
I think so, yeah. Okay. I don't know where Joe is.
Yeah, I don't know where Joe is.
No
idea.
Okie
dokie. Okay, here we go. One of my favourite ones to play over mic night with you guys, so
I love it.
Taste those strawberries on a summer evening, and it sounds like a song.
What was that?
Don't stop.
I want more berries than that summer feeling. Feel so wonderful, warm. Breathe me in, breathe me out. I don't know.
God, this is so weird not being able to hear anything or anyone, isn't it? Oh my Lord. It's like going back to like going live again, isn't it? On Facebook. Facebook Live. I don't like it. I don't like it. Okay. I'm gonna do a little bit of Ain't No Sunshine if that's okay. A little bit of an older track.
Sunshine when she's gone, it's no warm when she's away. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone, and she's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away, wonder this time where she's gone. Wonder if she's gonna stay. Cause ain't no sunshine, she's gone. In this house, just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away. And I know, 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 I know. Hey boy, leave that thing alone. Cause ain't no sunshine. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. Only darkness every day. Cause ain't no sunshine when she's gone. Yeah, she's always gone too long. Anytime she goes away. Anytime she goes away. Anytime she goes away. Thank you. Thanks. Lewis, why aren't you clapping? I'm joking. I'm joking. I'm going to do original if that's okay. Is that all right? Is that allowed? Yeah. Good. Perfect. This song is called Country Girl, and this is the one that
This is the one that we do over mic night quite a lot, so I hope you like it.
I sold my soul to the devil, being who I didn't want to be. Sometimes it's good to be an individual, and I should have just stayed me. Now I was searching for an answer, and I didn't like what I found. You found no greener pasture, should have kept your feet on the ground. And I hope someday you'll love me just the way.
Lewis has remembered how to clap.
Oh, thanks, Lou.
Never in doubt that one, was it?
good stuff. Just like the good old days.
How are we doing time-wise?
We're pretty much...
On 4 minutes.
Who's 7.30?
It's Shuxi.
Chiara, I think you're on at 7.30.
Chiara.
Yeah.
Chiara. Woo. So, your call, Roxy. You've got 4 minutes. 3 minutes.
Yeah, let's hand it over to Chiara, shall we?
Hey, I can fill a minute.
I can do another one. That's fine.
Do another one.
I can do another one, no problem. Okay, all right then. Okay.
Either you or me, I think you
should
do it.
No, it's fine. I'll do it. It's all good. Okie dokie. Let's go. Oh yeah, this one. I like this one. This is by Gabrielle, and this is another one that I usually do at the open mic night, so I haven't played it in so long. I miss you guys so much. This is so horrible. Okay, here we go. And then I'll promise I'll throw it to you, Chiara. Sorry.
Do the sound. Was I right? I was stupid. For a while, swept away by you, and I feel say of love by you out of reach so far. I never had your heart out of reach, couldn't see. We were never meant to be. Catch myself from despair. I can drown if I stay here. Keeping busy every day. I know I will be okay. But I was so confused. My heart's bruised. Was ever loved by you?
Thanks, guys. Cheers.
Yeah, bravo, bravo.
Thank you very much.
Wow, that's fantastic. Yeah.
Well done, Roxy. Toby says hi.
Hi, Toby.
So, next up, that was fantastic. The fantastic Roxy Searle, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Oh, yeah. Put your hands together. Come on.
Awesome, Rox. Awesome.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Can I just welcome someone I've seen in the bottom picture there looking very stern and serious?
Thank
Wayne,
you.
Unmute yourself, my friend.
How are you all?
Hey, how are you? Wayne, it's so good to see you. For those of you that don't know Wayne, Wayne is our genial host at the Speckled Hen when we're down there on a Wednesday night and we're out of lockdown.
And, here we are.
He is a champion landlord. Absolutely top quality landlord. He is a legend. It's great to come across a man who still believes in live music to his core.
And handles riff raff like a G.
Absolutely. So good, bye.
Da boss. Oh yeah.
You're not talking about me, Roxy, are you?
Yes.
Yeah, I heard you threw CLINT out. Yeah. Now, Wayne, good to see you, my friend.
And you, JD, and you. How's your family?
I heard about you handling the riffraff all the way down in Wales, where I'm down.
Yeah, we try.
Excellent job. So place. Great. So a big thank you to you for for supporting all of the open mics and for supporting CLINT. Fantastic. Right, I'm going to hand over now. I'm going to have a quick chat, if I may, with the fantastic Chiara Zorzetto. And Chiara, dove?
From Italy.
Adesso, dove? So where are you right now?
In Italy.
And where in Italy? Tell everybody.
Oh, well.
Just tell them where you're near, because they won't know.
Okay, yeah, I know. Near Venice.
So fantastic. So we have a truly international lineup. Wow. We've got someone coming all the way in.
What's
from
the time
Italy.
There?
1 hour ahead.
You're an hour ahead.
Sorry, I'm really bad at geography.
Yeah, no, that's telling the time.
Just
Yeah, so what's that? What what are you eating, Roxy? Clint wants to know what you're eating.
Always a fork. He's always a little sneaky fork coming from somewhere. What's she eating?
Okay, so I kind of thought it wouldn't be open mic night without me eating something. So
no, that's fair.
I'm eating a pie.
That's fair. Okay.
Sorry. I'm muting myself.
So Chiara, tell us a little bit about your relationship with Hertfordshire music scene.
Well, I play since 2014. So I just started playing guitar and then I write some songs. So I will play one or two of my own originals and I play also covers from any genre actually, but I prefer pop. Pop music is my favorite music.
Excellent. And you have played a lot in the UK, I understand.
Yep.
Okay, so tell us about playing in the UK. Where were you? Where have you played? Because you obviously have, because you know Clint.
Well, I played at the George in Itchen many times.
Ah, okay.
In Ware, at the Cooper Arms in Welling Garden City. Well, Welling North.
Fantastic.
Somewhere else. Another place.
So when you get back, when we finally end this lockdown, you'll be playing at the Speckled Hen. For sure.
I think so, yeah.
Excellent. So when you said your favorite kind of music is folk, pop. Was it?
No, pop.
Pop. Pop music. So are you going to give us any tonight?
Oh, tonight I'm going to play first Foo Fighters, that is not pop, but something else. And one song from Natalie Imbruglia. And I'll start with Foo Fighters with Learn to Fly.
Take it away. Take it away. All the way from Italy. Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen. Chiara Zorzetto.
Thanks. Run and tell all of the angels this could take all night. I think I need a devil to help me get things right. Hook me up on your revolution, cause this one is a lie. We set a love locked in and watch the last one die. And I'm looking to the sky to save me, looking for a sign of life, looking for something to help me burn out pride. I'm looking for a complication, looking to the tide of life. I'll make my way back home when I learn to fly. Think I'm diagnosing patient, it could wait one night. Give it all away, forgive me one last try. We leave happily ever trapped in future, save my life. I run and tell the angels that everything's alright. And I'm looking to the sky to save me, looking for a sign of life, and looking for something to help me burn out bright. I'm looking for a complication, looking for some time to thrive. I'll make my way back home when I learn to fly. I'll make my way back home when I learn to fly. Along with me, I can't quite make it alone. I'll try to make this life my own. Fly along with me, I can't quite make it alone. I'll try to make this life my own. I'm looking to the sky to save me, looking for a sign of life, looking for something to help me burn out bright. I'm looking for a complication, looking for some time to try. Make my way
Next song is another cover, and it's one from by Natalie Imbruglia, and it's called I Won't Be Lost. I'm gonna play one of my own songs, and this one is called How Do You Feel? Love you like I do. So
like a bad right dinosaur. To push away these blues, I'm just playing my guitar. And hope everything is good. But I'm still in love with you. Yeah, I'm still in love with you. Ain't nobody hurt me like you do. But ain't nobody love you like I do. So how do you feel? We burned this bridge down, set on fire all this town, just to find out. As a friend, all I want is you to see me. Here I am. We burn this bridge down, set on fire all this town, just to find out.
One more. I'm gonna play another
original. Chiara.
Yeah.
Hai una canzone originale in italiano?
No. No.
Oh.
Only English. Well.
Lasciatemi.
I don't know any song in Italian. This one is another original. I think it's the last one I've written. Yeah, it's the last one. And it's called Silly Game. When I look back in time, all I see is a great confusion. I can't explain. Words stuck behind a glass, but in the middle of this fog, you're still standing there. And I was waiting for an answer, and I was waiting for a closure.
Die.
just a silly game I don't wanna do anymore. It's just a silly game you keep doing without control. It's just a silly game I don't wanna do anymore. It's just a
I've got time for number one more. Okay, let's do another original. This one is called Tell Me.
That's brilliant. Well done. I love that.
Thanks.
That was pretty.
That was sick. That was nice.
Yeah. We've got like that. It was pretty. Looks like it's sick.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like I used to say, wicked back in
so, Chiara, it's your choice. If you want to do one more, you can, or we can push on to Steve's. Please, whatever you feel like doing.
We can push on. It's okay.
We're going to push on.
Yep.
In which case, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the fantastic Chiara Zorzetto.
Yeah.
Away from, quite away outside of Venice. So not quite far from anywhere in northern Italy. Are there good vineyards there?
What?
Are there good vineyards there?
Not here.
No, not in. Where
not
was
in
it?
My area.
Ah, no good. No
but
good.
It's not far.
Okay, fantastic. Well, I'm going to hand over to Roxy. It was great, Chiara. It was absolutely fantastic to hear you. Look forward to seeing you again and hearing you again. And as I say, after the lockdown, seeing you here in the UK. So, alla prossima volta. So, Roxy, over to you, my friend, because Hello. You have got the grand duty of interviewing Ted Nugent there.
With the cowboy hat.
Absolutely. I don't understand.
You're right. It's the hat, mate. It's the hat.
Oh, Ted. What? Ted Nugent, that name rings a bell.
Can you turn the rhythm off?
Yeah, yeah. He used to be well known in sort of kind of Hartford.
Oh. I know who he is, don't I?
Steve.
Is the reverb gone now?
That's perfect. Amazing. Cool.
I've
amazing.
Got to remember to stick it back on again.
Yeah, I'll remind you. Don't worry. How are you?
I'm good. I'm all right.
Good to have you here. It's so weird because normally we have you at the actual Speckled Hen, yeah. where you come and have a little jam with Clint and I and Lewis, don't you?
Yeah, I do indeed.
And yeah. it's so sad that we have to look at you through a screen. And the lovely ladies that normally come and watch you, they're not going to be able to see you tonight unless they're watching on Facebook. So if they are, you've got a message to send.
I've shared it on my page and I know that they're following it. So
you got a message for them.
Hi, lovely ladies from the Speckled Hen. I hope you're enjoying this live stream. And if you're not watching, then shame on you.
Oh, bless you. So what has kept you in survival mode during lockdown? What has kept you entertained during lockdown?
Entertained or alive? There's two very
different both. Things. Go on, both.
Well, what's kept me entertained is the grape.
The grape.
My four-legged friend.
Oh, little Tobes. How and is he?
He's all right. He's in his usual spot, his usual studio spot.
Oh, bless. For those of you who don't know, I normally take Toby out on a Tuesday. He's normally my little companion. He's my buddy on a Tuesday, isn't he? So I'm missing him. Bless him. So,
well, when am I ever allowed to go back to school, you can start walking him again.
Yeah. Get my buddy back.
So that was my four-legged friend on the guitar. That's what keeps me entertained. What keeps me alive is giving guitar lessons on Zoom.
Aww.
Basically. And the stock market.
How long have you been doing that for, Steve?
I've been teaching online since 2011.
Mm-hmm. Oh, blimey.
That's 10 okay. years.
That is 10 years. Yeah. Wow. Happy 10-year anniversary for you.
Although it escalated considerably in March.
Yeah, I bet it did. I bet it did. Have you got any new music coming out, Steve? I know that you are a man who literally records everything that he possibly can and gets it out as quickly as he can. And I envy that massively about you. So have you got any coming out?
I heard that you're going to buy Logic soon, so you can jump on that bandwagon, can't you? I have got new music. I have been writing songs during lockdown, and I went into the studio a couple of months ago with Clint on the drums.
Woo!
And the rest of my band, and we put down some tracks, and I'm still working on them at the moment, but I was working
Didn't need any backing vocals then, Steve, no?
And then working on them, and then a lovely lady sent me some of her tracks, and I ended up playing guitar on those instead. But yes, I do need your backing vocals, Roxy, as ever.
Wonderful. So, Let me know. Message me.
Yeah, so I'll have some new music coming out when I can actually get around to finishing all my guitar parts that I just keep changing every single day.
Amazing. I love it. Love listening to new guitar bits. If you had to choose, I've always wanted to ask you this question. If you had to choose, right, between your guitar and singing, what would you choose? So if you had to give one up and continue with another one, what would it be?
God, you know, that is so hard because I've been playing guitar for 30 years, okay? And I was a professional guitarist for years before I got fed up with all the singers I was working with and thought, you know what, I'm going to teach myself to sing. I was in my 30s before I even began trying to sing. But the weird thing is I've got more work and earned more money being able to sing than I ever have playing guitar.
Yeah.
So I don't know. It's just like, it's a different, they are two completely different ways of expression. And
yeah,
I think I'd have to go with the guitar because I could not not ever play the guitar again. unless you're actually going to like remove my voice box, I don't see how you could stop me from singing anyway.
Fair enough.
Yeah, it's a difficult one that, because weirdly, I always get more positive comments about my singing than I do my guitar playing, which is really depressing because considering I spent my life playing guitar.
You touched on it a little bit. You've performed with some really well-known people, haven't you? You've performed with Darren Hayes, haven't you, from Savage Garden?
Yes.
You've performed with, who was the musical theatre guy? I've forgotten his name.
Ramin,
amazing. Ramin. And you did live, was it morning show, didn't you?
I've done that a few times.
Yeah, you've done that a few times. You're quite
Darren. I did it with Lionel Richie. I did it with Darren. I did it with...
With Lionel Richie. Wait. Sorry, I've just caught it. I just caught your name drop. It's okay. Sorry. I've got it. It's fine. It's safe.
My first professional gig was... My first professional gig was Dane Bowers, and then it was Gareth Gates, and then it was Lionel Richie.
Oh, so what's the nicest person?
I kind of went up in increments.
What's the nicest person that you've worked with? Who was your favourite?
Nicest person, probably the nicest person in the short space of time that I met him was probably Peter Andre, because he was absolutely lovely.
My mum loves Peter Andre.
But the nicest person from a long-term point of view, because I was in a band with him for 5 years, would have to be Darren, because he's the guy that brought me my first MacBook Pro and got me into songwriting.
That's adorable. Now, my mum is literally absolutely in love with Darren Hayes.
Is she?
She's just pulled a very funny face. I will not pull that on here. But
she just thrown her knickers at the computer.
Yeah, literally. Gay, bless her heart. Yeah, yeah. My dad just went, but he's gay, so it's okay. She can love him. So, okay, if you could open up for anyone in the world, who would it be?
You.
Aww. Okay, apart from me, because you're going to be in my band anyway, so
it would have to be living or dead.
Either.
Assuming that I can actually pull it off, because obviously any of these names I'm about to say I would fall flat on my face in front of their weirdly confused, gobsmacked fans. But I would love to open for someone like Pink Floyd or Eric Clapton. But in both cases, I'd probably get booed off the stage because they wouldn't know who I was.
No, I doubt that. I thought you was going to say something like Eagles or someone like that, or Fleetwood Mac.
No.
But No. I'll shove that question up my arse then. if you could change anything about the industry, what would it be? So the industry is in the music industry, our kind of industry, so like gigging and that kind of industry. Is there anything that you'd change about it?
there's some things I'd like to change that would get me in a lot of trouble if I was to just say them now.
Okay.
What would I like to change? I don't know how to answer that question. without just pissing off the entire
without upsetting everyone. Okay, we'll move on, because I don't want to make you say anything that you don't want.
The industry is a business, and you either provide a product that makes money or you don't. And unfortunately, products that make money have absolutely sod all to do with being able to play or have talent. So so I would probably change that aspect, but then there would be no industry, would there? Because it's the talentless idiots that make all the money so that they can spend money on old farts like me. So, you know, it's the necessary evil.
It is. Okay. Fair enough. Right. Risky, I'm going to ask you one. I know. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I apologize. I'm so sorry. So I'm going to ask you one more question because I don't want to hold you up any longer. And I'm sure everyone is dying to hear you play. What is your favourite pie filling?
It's going to be...
okay, I want a savoury and a sweet.
Oh, I don't eat sweet. Oh, yes, I do. Okay, savoury would be steak and ale pie.
Banging.
And sweet
would be... Would you have any Stilton in there?
No. Stilton sweet, has sweet, its place. Sweet not in a pie. it's like people that put peanut butter in baked beans. I mean, just take them out and shoot them. now.
What? Peanut butter with baked beans?
Yeah, have you not heard about that?
I'm genuinely quite disturbed by this.
Don't try it. It's disgusting.
No, I will not. Okay, what's your favourite cheese?
I tell you what I like. I mean, I'm pretty traditional, cheddar. I like the Mexican chili stuff, and I like that, I can never say it, balsami soft garlic stuff. What's it called?
Is it balsam?
What's it?
Balsam.
Yeah, that's the one. I can never say it.
Okay.
Yeah, ballsack.
Yeah. I'm good with my cheese. Not that kind of cheese, Steve. Not that kind of cheese. Jesus. Okay, what was your sweet pie filling?
Mince pie, Christmas.
Mince pie. Okay. All right, I'll give you that. Okay.
I don't eat any.
So without further ado, you don't eat any other pie? Not even like a cherry pie?
Oh, no. Sweet cherry pie? No, I don't like cherry pies. No.
No?
No. Actually, I used to like apple crumble at school.
Apple crumble. That's not really a pie. That's a crumble. But okay, we'll get out of the technicals. Anyway, thank you so much for joining us today. And I'm really gutted that I'm not hearing you properly live, because that really sucks. But we're going to have to make do with this. So what are you going to be singing for us today, Steve?
Some
originals, I hope.
I'm going to do this one. I love this song. And basically I was challenged to learn it the other day.
Okay.
Robert Downey Jr. does a really good version of it. And that was the version that I was listening to. I didn't really realise it's actually a bit of a Christmas song, but let's just forget that. That's the first one. It's a cover.
Okay.
And then after that, what would you like to hear, Roxy?
I'd like to hear you play Country Girl.
I don't know the words. Oh my God, can you hear Toby snoring?
It's Toby snoring, I can hear that. Oh, bless. I like you playing Train.
Train?
Now she's back in the atmosphere with drops of Jupiter in her head.
I don't know that song. Can you just choose a song that I actually
know? You played that one. You played that. Yes, you do.
I've never played
that
song.
You played that at The Crown. Anyway.
You're getting me mixed up.
All right. Let's hear some.
Can you seriously not hear him snoring?
Really not. Yeah, I can. What a dude. Guys, come on. What do you guys want to hear? Here as well. I want to hear an original. Did you just shush me?
Yeah, because I want you to listen to Toby snoring.
Original. Back to mine. That's what I want to hear.
Okay. All right.
Back to mine. Definitely.
Do I have permission to put my reverb back on?
All right.
Steve, is it possible at some point you could play Tennessee Whiskey?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, yeah, Tennessee Whiskey.
Okay.
Steve, that's a shout.
Oh, Steve.
Right. Steve. Yes. Stephen, get back onto your reverb and do your thing.
Toby, stop snoring, please. Daddy's got work to do. Thank you.
Cutting down trees, putting up reindeer, and singing songs of joy and peace. I wish I had a river I could skate away on. But it don't snow here, it stays pretty green. Make a lot of money, gonna quit this crazy scene. I wish I had a river that I could skate away on. I wish I had a river so long I would teach my feet to fly. Oh, I wish I had a river I could skate away on. And I made my baby cry. Me so naughty, maybe we weak and the knees. Oh, I wish I had a river I could skate away on. So hard to handle, I'm selfish and I'm sad. I lost my baby, the best I ever had. I wish I had a river I could skate away on. I wish I had a river so long, teach my feet to fly. Oh, I wish I had a river I could skate away on. But may my baby say goodbye. Trees, putting our reindeer, singing songs of joy and peace. I wish I had a river could skate away on. I don't know how to end this song, whether it's the G or if it's the D or the C. Oh, I made my baby end the song on a G.
Was that the actual lyrics at the end, or did you just not know? I like that. That was funny.
I have nice no improv. Idea how to end it.
Nice improv. Ladies and gentlemen, this song is Back to Mine, and this is by Steve Young, and it is amazing.
Thanks, Oxy. This pain go away.
they were coming from. Your face and your eyes, they burn in my mind. So we can't turn back the time. Rest your head next to mine.
Amazing, absolutely amazing. Just letting you know, Steve, Jules is watching and she was really pleased that you played that song.
Jules?
Yeah.
Cool. I thought you said Jaws. I was like,
no.
Jules.
Yeah, Jules.
Excellent. All right, cool. All right. Is it a bit distorted, did someone say?
Just a tiny bit. I think it's just the volume.
I'll just drop the level on Zoom a little bit.
Okie dokie.
Not Zoom, sorry. Logic. Why did I? I'll just drop the level on Logic a little bit. There you go. There you go. You fussy lot. I was probably getting a bit too close to the microphone as well. Tennessee whiskey, you're a sweet
I search for love in all the usual places. But the bottom of the bottle, oh, it's always dry. When you came to me and poured your heart out, yeah, I didn't waste it. Nothing like your love to keep me high. Sure and smooth, Tennessee whiskey. You're a sweet strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy. The ice stays stone. Your love all the time. You're a sweet strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy. On the ice stay stone. Your love all the time.
Have I got time? What am I doing? Am I still playing?
You've who's got loads charge? Of time. Loads of time, buddy.
Who's
loads
in charge? Time. All right, cool.
You got this.
Let me do an original. What do you want to hear, Roxy? Or anyone? An original?
Oh, there's so many. Go on. What did you think I was going to say?
You're going to say this one. Just realised Toby hasn't had a pee since 12 o'clock. Are you alright, Toby? Sorry, I forgot to let you out. Have you got your legs crossed? Bad dad.
Stance, fish your feet on the path up ahead. Soft grass will soothe you, brush your cold legs. When you cry softly so no one can hear, I'll be here waiting to hold back your tears. Cause you, only love I'm loving your trembling heart.
Steve, that was amazing.
Welcome. Hello, Pippa.
Oh,
Pippa.
Yeah. It's just like, hello.
Cool. Is that it? Me done?
Who is it?
I mean, I think JD's handed over. I think he's had to shoot. But I think, you know, we're technically on the money by 1 minute. So it's up to you, Steve. You want to do another one to finish, or are you happy?
Can I do like a brand new one?
Yeah, man.
Go for it.
Actually, Clint, you know this one.
Is this a brand new? Is this a brand new original, or is this a brand new cover?
It's a brand new original that only Clint knows because he's played drums on it.
Ooh.
And extra points for the older ones that can that get the reference to the song that this is basically. Is it? I don't know if it's a pastiche, a homage, or just a blatant ripoff. I don't know. Actually, I do mention the song in the chorus, so actually it should be really easy. There's a sad, sad song on the tip of my tongue. Words are always waiting there. Natural demeanor, look into the abyss. Wants a happy song anyway. Not today. I can write a song as good as more than words. Believe me when I say I try. Cause every day I love you just a little more. Hoping that you realize. Yeah, I'm hoping that you realize. Life has been so much pain. Hypochondriac to broken love. Every time I try to get something's feeling good, these memories keep me stuck in reverse. You're going the wrong way. I can write a song as good as more than words. Believe me when I say I try. Cause every day I love you just a little more. Hoping that you realize. Yeah, I'm hoping that you realize.
said a million different times. And I believe the love is shown in what you do, a measure of a life over time. It's just you and me, babe. And I can write a song as good as more than words. Believe me when I say I try. Every day I love you just a little more, hoping that you realize. Yeah, I can write a song as good as more than words. Believe me when I say I try. 'Cause every day I love you just a little more, hoping that you realize. Yeah, I'm hoping that you realize.
So it was Mr. Brightside, yeah?
Yes, Mr. Brightside.
I had an advantage that I kind of knew.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I forgot. To be honest, I forgot that I mentioned it in the chorus before I said that. I'm an idiot.
I mean, that is extremely obvious to most people. Good homage. Yeah.
So what do you reckon? Pasties, homage, or rip-off?
What's the most polite word out of those three?
Homage.
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 Homage is good enough for me.
Cool.
Is everyone off of mute now?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
I'd like to thank Steve. Yeah. If you don't know Steve already, I'm sure you do if you're on, because you do to get on to see him. But if you don't, go check Steve out. Steve Young, Facebook.
Steve Young UK.
Steve Young UK. It has to be UK.
Otherwise, otherwise you get some American footballer.
Yeah, I get that. There's another guy called...
And he can't play any songs. He's rubbish.
This other guy's not even. So we want to have a quick thank you as well before, you know, obviously thanks go to Roxy, Clara, Steve, both Steves, everyone else in the back. JD was helping out, Joe, who's obviously disappeared off to work.
Clint, who was amazing as well. Clint, well done. Thank you for getting dressed up for us.
I was going to do it at the end, my big one. I had a good excuse to get dressed up tonight. My neighbours thought I was really weird when I went to put the bins out.
Oh, wow.
It's strange. Obviously, massive thanks as well going to Speckled Hen. We're very much being back there. So a round of applause for those guys. I'm sure you'll let us know when that's allowed.
Yes.
At the moment, we all know the same. Not yet.
And also, Logic did sound amazing, didn't it?
So whatever Steve was going through, sounds really good. I'll have to phone you about that, Steve, so tweak up my output a bit. That's a good output sound, I thought.
Yeah.
Would you like to say anything, Joe?
No, thank you for everybody for joining, and it's really appreciated. Obviously, if you guys would like to make some donations, that goes to Feed Up Warm Up. So nice little charity there. JD's put an extra £50 in the pot. We're going to put an extra £30 in the pot on Friday. So I'll give a running total of that next week. I've just got to say thank you for everybody for joining, because I know, you know, it's your free time, and you know, it's very hard to make living off events at the moment. But the plan is to try and get the circulation as high as possible. Once circulation is high as possible, then we can actually try and monetize the actual event itself, so you guys can
share the wealth, Joseph. Yeah. Share the wealth.
Brilliant, definitely amazing.
Share the wealth. Perfect. So thank you. So much. But yeah, I love you all. Thank you.
Tweeting. We can go for another one next week.
Yes, 100%. I've got acts already sorted out, so whoever's on board, let me know. But yeah, definitely got all the acts sorted and ready for next week.
Who have you got for next week?
Next week, I've got Aigo. I've got somebody from Liverpool. And then I'm still got work on the other two acts. So if you guys have got anybody in mind or something,
might be me.
You can go from that.
We want to see Clint play.
Of course, I want to see.
We want to see Clint play.
Not on my own, you don't.
Yeah, just on the drums. That's it. And then hopefully, when Clint teaches me enough, I can come and do a drum solo or something like that. music.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much. Thanks for having us all. Thank you for hosting it. And thanks to everyone.
I have to go to work now, but thank you guys. Love you all.
All good.
All cool. Right, so guys, what I'm going to do, just so you know, in a joke, can you stop the live feed for us?
Yes, I will do that.
Say goodbye to Facebook people.
Bye, Facebook people.
Bye, Facebook people.
Thank you for being faces in books.
Yes,
thank you.
I'm doing some really weird wave. I don't know, when my hands disappear.
You're doing the family fortunes wave.
I'm still live. We're still live.
Yeah.
It's just a time delay, Clint.
Oh, yeah, there is a time delay, Steve. Are we still
in my head.
Oh, hang on. I can change it here.
Oh, you do
it. Stop live stream. Oh, he's made me host. Okay, right.
Yeah.
Okay, goodbye, everyone.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.